Chronic lymphocytic leukemia, or CLL, is a cancer of a particular type of white blood cell known as a B lymphocyte. And these lymphocytes become cancerous, they become a leukemia, and they divide without regulation, and they don't ever die. CLL cells in particular like to then establish themselves in protective niches, like the spleen, the lymph nodes, and the bone marrow too. So as the disease develops, patients can develop in large lymph nodes, they can develop in large spleen, and their bone marrow, which is the factory where normal blood cells are produced, can be taken over by CLL cells. Patients can develop symptoms related to these things, so certainly symptoms related to having big lymph nodes in their neck, under their arms, symptoms related to having a big spleen, like a loss of appetite. And if the bone marrow becomes full of CLL cells, the normal blood counts, like the hemoglobin, which is the red blood cell count, and the platelet count will start to decrease. The treatment of CLL has really changed dramatically over the past 10 to 20 years. Most recently, the paradigm has really been shifted by the introduction of a number of targeted therapies that have recently been shown to be better than chemotherapy in the treatment of CLL. We can now say that most patients, when they're diagnosed with chronic lymphocytic leukemia, will not actually be treated with chemotherapy in their life. Traditionally, cancers have been treated with chemotherapy drugs, which are very non-specific drugs that kill everything that they can, which usually means every cell in the body that is dividing very quickly. That can include cancer cells, but also includes a lot of normal cells and can cause a lot of toxicity. So in CLL, we found that there are certain targets or proteins that are really important to keeping those cells alive. And at the James, we're actually working in the laboratory on a number of different targets that we think are going to be very beneficial in the treatment of patients so that we can selectively kill cancerous cells while sparing normal tissue.